Hi. That's a nice shot. That's the biggest snow shorter owl I've ever seen. That's the snowy a couple days prior. Way out in the back. These owls are in pretty good now. I got the short-eared last yesterday, and it wasn't that dark out. Not that many people, and the conditions were, pretty good. We had a good circus, whatever you want to call it. So I don't know what that is. Some kind of hawk, maybe. There's your short-eards now. Now, it was dark when I first started shooting, so what you're dealing with is a shutter speed, and you want to open the lens as much as you can, I think, on your f-stop, but on your aperture. But the ISO, you gotta get generous with the ISO as you're, the shutter speed for flying, and that's gonna raise your ISO even more, ISO. And you have the background that you're dealing with on the photo, plus I go with exposure compensation. So I'm shooting into the light sometimes, so I might as well just say, I'll go with like a +2 on a shot like that, and they come in pretty good. But there's other cases where if there's a very dark background, the picture's not that great. So it's a hit or miss, bell curve or whatever you want to call it. And then at the end, I got into this leaving, and it was very dark out, and somehow my camera got bumped over. And I was shooting 1600 on a shutter speed, which is impossible, and it was a holding still bird. But the ISO was like 35,000, 3,500, and 3,500 or whatever. But see, so your settings are going to be in a situation like that. Your settings aren't bad. That's a good shot there, and the settings are coming in good. There's two at once. I did get up to three at the same time. There's three in that picture. I don't know what to say about that. It just, with experience, I guess people do that. Go along. Now, if you're panning with the bird, you get away with a lower shutter speed than if you're just holding still and snapping, because then you're pacing along with the bird, or the bird's flying across the view where the camera's shooting. If you go with it a little bit and you get a better shot. I was using a monopod, and I sit on the tailgate of the truck, and I can, it's right about a good level for a monopod. Other people like the tripods. I mean, I have an old tripod, but it's not a gimbal. There's the largest short-eared owl I've ever seen. I thought this was a barred owl until it turned its head, and then it's got the bright, there it is, see the yellow? Bright yellow, and it's got that short-eared owl face on it. So it's, not a horned owl or anything like that. But this bird was huge for a short-eared owl. It was gigantic. It's the biggest one I've ever seen. I haven't seen that many of them. They're kind of scarce now. But it's taking a nice picture. But see, that's a 3500 with 1600 shutter speed and a 3500 ISO, which got bumped over, which I could have had, and it's sitting still, so I could have my settings a lot better than that. But it was the end of the night and it was dark anyway. So the camera's not a bad camera for low light.